How have I had fun in sobriety? My first year was really, really genius. I was on a pink cloud for almost all of it. When I heard that we can be of service, when I heard that speaker say to me that if you have one day more than somebody that you can help them, I set out on a new journey. I have done things like create movie nights. I have taken camping trips with my friends. I organize so much. It's just, I feel really blessed in this program. I feel that God has provided me with a bountiful of friends and emotion, and it's so much that I have to give back. So I do a lot of things. On my 1 year party, we kind of threw a rave. My big philosophy, you know, when I first came into these rooms, let's go way back. When I first came in, I thought my life was over. The reason what kept me stopping from entering or being sober was I thought that once I hit sobriety, my life ended. You know, the fun stopped and everything. And bit by bit, I started learning that sobriety wasn't the stop of a life. It was the starting of a new one. And I got to recreate who I was. So with that knowledge, and I just really learned that the only thing that we don't do, the only difference that we do in our sober lives is that we just don't drink or use, that nothing has to change. So for my 1 year party, I had a rave. We had two battling DJs, I want to say tweaker lights, but rave lights. We had rock star Jello shots, which it's just, I wanted to prove a point that just because we're sober, the only thing that has to be different in our lives is just we don't have to pick up or use to have the same amount of fun. That really made an effect on a lot of people's lives. I heard daily that I didn't know that this could be sober. No one thought it was a sober party. It was that much fun. Since then, I have entered or had fun. For some reason, they think it's really funny to throw me in a dress and to be of service. And again, I don't turn down AA requests. So whatever it is, you know, I understand that my life is so full because I don't say no anymore. Life is bountiful, and sobriety and fun just go hand in hand. I have had belly laughs. And I mean, yeah, you laugh when you're high or whatever, drunk, but the belly laughs, the deep, soulful belly laughs that come out because sobriety is that much fun, because you can remember, you can feel again, and nothing else is repressed. You know, we don't have to hide anymore. So fun and sobriety is definitely one of my main purposes. The meeting that we sometimes do and we take in traveling is called Creative Solutions in Sobriety, because it's all about bridging the gap, you know, the lacking of fun that we think we're leaving behind. So it's a lot of fun. That's all the word I can have for you. It's just a basic passion of mine, is making sure that every newcomer that comes to that door remembers and knows that nothing's changed. The only thing that's changed is we don't pick up or use anymore. And we have just as much fun, if not more, because now it's all real. Now it's not fabricated by adding an additive to our lives. It's not, it's all real feelings, you know? And it's really important to me, and it's definitely one of my passions. And like I said before, I am so full of gratitude for this program, for teaching me how to live again and giving me a purpose to give back and a means. So thanks.